We're in the sensory system 3. We're going to talk about the auditory system and the last two chemical senses. Let's start with the auditory. Auditory system pick up the sound, and sound is the media, usually it's air, sometimes it's water, movement. And the sound is very straightforward. You only have two components, the wave amplitude, that's the loudness, and the frequency, that's how many waves you have per second, and only have these two components. So if I take all the media out, you actually hear nothing. So you need to have the media, usually it's the air, and the sound gonna press the air in the wave form. So if you put a stream in front of your speaker, you actually can see the stream being pushed back and forth, because it's the energy. Your auditory system is designed to pick up the energy, the sound wave. So your ear can be divided into the outer part, middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear, external ear, including the pinnae and the acoustic meatus, the ear canal, their function is to collect in sound. So I can cut this part off, you can still hear, because they collect the sound. And the bigger ear you have, the more sound you can collect. So you see some animals, the bigger the pinnae, they can turn, it helps them to collect sound. The first one response to the sound wave is this tympanic membrane. That's the eardrum. So that's the starting point of the middle ear. The middle ear, you have the tympanic membrane. You have three ossicles, O-S-S-I-C-L-E, ossicles. They are the smallest bone you can find in your body. The malleus, incus, stapes. The all three connected together, like the hinge joint. Very similar to your shoulder, to your arm. If you think about, okay, this part is your shoulder. I push your shoulder, your arm, and to your hand, push. That's the function of the middle ear. All mechanical. So auditory system is all mechanical. We transfer the sound mechanical force into the push, to the pressure movement. And of course, if you damage these ossicles, you damage those auditory system, and you become deaf. It's called mechanical deafness. It can be caused by damage of this. And this tube, it goes to the nasopharynx. Nasopharynx. Pharynx is a fancy word to say throat. So it goes to your throat. And you may hear some people have middle ear infection, especially for kids. And that's because the bacteria can go from here to here, cause middle ear infection. This tube, auditory tube, its main function is to balance the pressure. So when you take the airplane, sometimes when the airplane taking off and landing, you feel your ear hurt. The reason is the pressure here and here are not balanced. And some people will teach you, okay, hold your nose and blow with your mouth closed. And you fix it in 1 second, because you press the pressure back to here. So now you balance this pressure. You feel much better. It also happens in people who play scuba diving. When they dive to the certain distance, the pressure from the water gonna press it. It hurt a lot. So they have to blow their nose every time they go to certain depths. So that's the middle ear. That's the middle ear. And apparently when the bacteria go to here and they're pretty happy, they're gonna grow. So that's middle ear infection. Why it happens more frequently in kids than adult? Because anatomy, the head size. The kid's head size is smaller, so it's easier for bacteria to travel from here to here. That's the only reason. And adult, they also can have middle ear infection. And now let's go to the inner part. This is the inner ear. And the inner ear including the semicircular canal, vestibule, and cochlea. So we're going to spend a lot of time talking about the inner ear. This is like the retina in the eye. So they transfer the sound into the neurotransmitter release and action potential. So that's the middle ear. It's all mechanical. So you found auditory system is all mechanical. And it's not as fancy compared with the visual system. It transfers the light into chemical response. So that's the photochemical response. Auditory is all mechanical. And it become more affordable. We'll talk about this. And So some animals, they cannot afford the visual system. Visual system is an expensive toy. So only the high-level species have very good visual system, like the birds, mammals. The other low-level species, they have to rely on the other system, like the auditory system, and it's their main sensory system. So this is all mechanical. This muscle, its function is to tight the bone. So the surface area of the tympanic membrane to the stapes is about 60 times. So it increases the signal. You only need a little bit sound and you can push. But imagine you go to a very loud room. This is gonna damage, gonna cause hurt. So this is the feedback. This is the feedback. And when you go to a very loud environment and your brain say, oh, too loud. So it will actually tight the tensor tympani. If you took anatomy, you learn this muscle. Its function is to make it tight. So it won't amplify the signal anymore. So it's a protective mechanism. Protect your auditory system won't get hurt when you go to a super loud environment. This is a feedback, so it takes time to process. If you have a very sharp, loud noise, this won't help you. For example, gunshot. So if you like to go to the range and shoot, you still need to wear ear protection because this feedback won't be able to help you. Okay, now let's go to the inner ear. So the inner ear has three semicircular canal and vestibule. So this part, this for balancing. We will only briefly talk about this. We're going to mainly talk about this. This is the cochlea, this is the auditory. So your cranial nerve together, their output together called vestibular cochlea nerve and cranial nerve number 8, because you have the balance part and the auditory part. And sound is a wave. So this wave is going to transfer from the outside, and this wave, your outer ear, its function is to transduct the signal from the outside to the inside. And the first one response to the vibration is the tympanic membrane, the middle ear. And it's all mechanical, so they're going to push, like a hinge joint, push. They're going to push the transfer the sound wave into the movement of the three ossicles. And once they push, that's the inner ear. The inner ear, the cochlea, now they extend it. It's easier to explain with extended. It's filled with a liquid called endolymph. And endolymph is a liquid filled with potassium. We'll talk about it later. And they're going to push the liquid. So the liquid on the top part flow in, the bottom part flow out. And they're going to vibrate this part called organ of Corti. That's the most important part. They're like the retina in the eye. So it's all mechanical. Auditory system is all mechanical. So you can damage those machine different part and damage it. That's called the mechanical deafness. And if you damage the neuron in the cochlea or after that, this is called neuronal deafness. So we have two different kinds of deafness. And the concept, the sound from the outside, transfer to the eardrum movement, transfer to the three ossicle movement, transfer to the endolymph movement, and eventually they're going to go through here. So let's look at the cochlea and organ of Corti. So they have, it's coil back, but for explanation, they have to extend it. It's easier to explain it with extended form, but it actually coil back in your inner ear. And it's made of like those empty tube, and only this small part, very similar to the eyes. The eyes, most of them are the water, the jello, the vitreous humor. And the most important part is that piece of paper called retina. An auditory system, well, is filled with liquid. And I call this sandwich, called the organ of Corti, because you have hair cells sandwiched by two membranes, and this part, they transfer the sound into the neuronal signal. So let's look at this part, organ of Corti. Okay, that's the organ of Corti, and that's the hair cells. They're like rods and cones in the visual system. And these hair cells, they have hair, okay, that's why they call hair cells, and on the top part, tectorial membrane, and the bottom part, basilar membrane. And imagine the liquid on the top part flow in, the bottom part flow out, because that's when the sound move in, you're gonna push the liquid flow. And now these hair cells sandwiched by two membranes, the bottom part the top part move inward, the bottom part moving outward, they're gonna bend the hair. And that's how they transfer the sound into the mechanical movement. So on the hair cells, what kind of ion channel do they have? Mechanically gated ion channel. So now we see the third kind of ion channel. We talk about the voltage gated, we talk about the ligand gated. Now we see the mechanically gated ion channel. So that's the hair cells, and they have hair. And these hairs, endolymph, that's a liquid. The liquid has high potassium. And on the top of the hair, you have the mechanically gated potassium channel. And when the hair cells move, they move to one direction, they move back, the ion channel will be pulled open. And then when they move back, they close. So they can code the frequency perfectly, code the sound frequency perfectly. And when we talk about potassiums in unit one, when we talk about the membrane physiology, the ions flow, and you know potassium gonna flow out when you open the ion channels. And the reason is because potassium usually is high inside than outside. And for ion channel, it's a facilitated diffusion. They actually don't care which direction the ion flows. So the driving force, what's the driving force? Concentration gradient. So it depends on the concentration gradient. Potassium usually high inside, low outside. It's going to flow out when the ion channel is open. But in this case, endolymph, very unique. It's high potassium outside. So when you open the potassium channel in the hair cells, the high potassium, low potassium, potassium actually flow in from high to low, always follow the concentration gradient. And when the potassium flow in, potassium has positive charge, well, it still depolarizes the cell. So it's very similar, the same concept as sodium flow in. This is the only difference is this time is potassium, because endolymph has high potassium. So again, it teaches you for the ion channel is facilitated diffusion, the driving force, concentration gradient. They will follow the concentration gradient. And this slide explains when the hair cells flow, they perfectly code the frequency, because when they move to one direction, the ion channel open, depolarize, and when they move back, it close. So they can perfectly code the frequency of the sound, and they're able to transfer them to neurotransmitter release. And because these the hair cells are good boys and good girls, they're not like the rods and cones. They don't follow the rules. So in on the retina, you need to have a bipolar cell to transfer them back. Then the ganglia cells generate action potential. In the ear, well, the hair cells, they behave normally. And when you have a bigger sound, they wave more and release more neurotransmitter. So they perfectly code the frequency of the sound. You don't need a bipolar cell. So you only need two, the hair cells and ganglia cells. Receive those hair cells, release neurotransmitter, and the ganglia cells generate action potential, because only action potential can travel for long distance. And now let's look how the ear code different frequency. When you hear a sound, you don't hear a high frequency first, then the low frequency. And every time you produce the sound, unless you use the tuning fork. Tuning fork is the one only produce one frequency. And even though you play instrument, you play a tone, it's a combination of five different frequencies together. And when you go to the concert, obviously there's a hundred of different frequencies. Apparently your ear can process different frequencies at the same time. You don't have time delay. So you can combine all these frequencies together, say, oh, that's a cello, that's a violin, that's a guitar, that's a piano, or that's your grumpy boyfriend. Oh, sorry. Yeah. You are able to do that, and the reason is because your ears process different frequencies at the same time. And let's look how they are able to do that. So that's the basilar membrane. That's the basilar membrane, and that's your inner ear. You extend it, and the key is you have different populations of hair cells. They are able to process different frequencies at the same time. So they transfer the different frequencies into different location. In mechanic, it's called the Fourier transform. You don't need to know the term is mechanic. They transfer it into different location. Okay, let's take a short break. We'll come back, keep talking about this.